Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make better selections and cutouts with a powerful color range trick. If we wanted to select the flowers in this image, one of the easiest ways to do so will be to go to the select menu and choose color range. From here, we can click on the eyedropper tool and click on a color to select. For example, the red that makes up the flowers, and we can add to that selection by clicking on the Add to Sample eyedropper and clicking and dragging. A selection preview that I like for this technique is the white matte because it shows us the colors that we've selected. And as you can see, we're selecting the flowers like we wanted to, but we're also selecting the red dress, the lips, and part of the skin tone because there's red in there. If I press OK, of course, the selection will include those areas. So, how do we exclude the model from the selection? And that's the main point of this tip, how to exclude something from color range. And it's actually very simple. All you need to do is make a selection. I'll start by pressing Ctrl D, Command D to deselect to get rid of that selection. Then I can select the quick selection tool, click and drag to select the model. You don't need a perfect selection. This selection is fine. I just need to make sure that none of the flowers are selected. If you accidentally selected an area that you want to keep, just hold Alt on Windows, Option on the Mac, and click and drag to deselect. Then I'll right-click and choose Select Inverse. That inverts the selection, so everything that was selected is no longer selected, and what was not selected is now selected. That means that the model is no longer selected, and everything else is. If you go into Select, Color Range, you will notice that Photoshop will only look at the contents of the selection to create the mask. With the same settings, I can press OK, and you'll notice now that the flowers are selected and nothing else in the image is. I can then create an adjustment layer, such as the Hue and Saturation adjustment layer, and adjust the color of the roses. Click on that like button now if this trick was new to you. Let me know down in the comments below if you plan on using this technique. If you want to see more Photoshop tips and tricks like this one, then check out all my 90-second Photoshop tips. I'll place a link right below in the description. Thank you so much for watching.